Hi, Sophie here. Welcome back to my channel. I love painting with grease pencil. I think that's been established by now. But something I've been struggling with lately has been how to finalize a painting in grease pencil. Finalizing is a tricky part of the creative process because it's maybe the part of the process that we have the least experience doing. I know I have many unfinished pieces. I'm very used to starting new pieces, and I also have a lot of practice making quick sketches, but I have a lot less experience with making big pieces, intricate and detailed pieces, and I have probably the least experience with finishing them. And so I'm going to be using these tricks on this painting, which is a recent finished piece that I'm extremely proud of, but on which I had not used any of these tricks. And so when I was planning out this video, I very quickly just tested all of this out to make sure that they would work, that this was a worthy video of making. And the difference that it made in just 10 quick minutes. So I can't wait for us to see now the final result. So I like to think about painting and rendering as a kind of dance, a push and pull, making some areas lighter, making others darker, adding saturation or removing it. And when I get to the finalizing portion of a piece, for me, this is mainly about simplifying some areas so that they blend together and draw less attention, adding complexity to other areas, making the rendered parts of the piece look beautifully blended, while also letting some parts of the piece remain sketchy and almost unfinished. For me, it's all about emphasizing what I've been building towards with this whole painting process and making sure that what I want to stand out is standing out, the focal point of the piece, and making sure that the less important and secondary details are doing their job. They're adding to the piece without drawing too much attention to themselves and away from the focal area of the piece. So the way that I'm gonna do it to show the back and forth, the before and after, I mean, of all of these changes that I'm gonna make, is that I've turned auto keying on just for this example, not a setting I normally use. And so I'm gonna do all of this on frame two so that I can just use the left and right arrow keys to show us the before and after. And so the first tool that we're gonna use is the thickness tool in sculpt mode. With how I use grease pencil to render, which is by adding a lot of very small strokes and low opacity strokes that I glaze on top of one another, this makes the thickness tool amazing for adding softness to a grease pencil painting. So although one thing that I love about grease pencil is that every stroke exists independently, can be selected and modified separately from all the other strokes, in this case we're not gonna do that. So while we're in sculpt mode, we're gonna turn off any selection mask option up here and have none of them selected. And I will also be doing this with all of the layers of my piece unlocked. So because I mentioned this being kind of like a push and pull dance, sometimes I'm also holding down on control while I use the thickness tool to have the reverse effect. And so the thickness tool is one of the most satisfying that we're gonna look at. So what this tool actually makes me think of is watercolor pencils. So one way that you could use watercolor pencils is to scribble color into an area, draw into an area, and then you add water, which softens, makes those lines bigger, and blends them together. So like with all of these tools, since we're modifying the piece as a whole, I recommend taking this slow press lightly to have the tool affect the area less strongly. And if you don't have a tablet and stylus, you can modify the strength of the tool up here. I also undo and redo a lot, and I also toggle the before and after quite frequently to make sure that every change that I make is a positive one. So I would say, looking back and forth, this step has been a success. The main thing I'm noticing is that the different areas of color feel a lot more grouped to me. And so it got rid of some lines that maybe broke up the area. It softened areas, and overall, I think the form reads more clearly. For the next tool, we're going to go into draw mode and we will be using the eraser tool. So in general, I don't really use Grease Pencil's eraser tool. When I want to erase strokes or points, I typically prefer to do that in edit mode by selecting and deleting exactly what I want. But I recently came upon a use for the eraser tool a bit accidentally. So my finger would be resting on the control button as I went to add strokes in draw mode, and that would trigger the eraser tool. And in some cases, I really liked the result. So I wanted to see what I could do with that. So I've shared about this before, but I like to start my pieces with some quite absurd texture fill strokes. And so my painting process is, in a way, a process of cleanup, of making something detailed and rendered out of a messy beginning. But sometimes things can get overworked and messy isn't necessarily a bad thing. And so in this case, of course I want to keep the head and the main body of this creature very rendered, and so I'm not touching those parts too much with the eraser tool. But I think the feet, as they were drawing a bit too much attention, and really the piece is not about the feet. And so by spending a lot of time with the eraser tool on the feet, what we're left with at the end is a painting where there's still no doubt that those are feet and that it's a nature scene, but I really like that that part of the piece is more sketchy. So this next tool is, in a way, the opposite of the previous tool. So for this, I use just a solid stroke material, and I bring the size, the radius of the brush as high as it can go, larger even than the slider goes. So I double click on the size slider and type in 5,000. Also, make sure you're at the topmost layer, and you can even add a new layer for this. We are looking to simplify, to unify. This has to do with, like I mentioned, grouping areas so that they don't draw as much attention if that's not what we want, and making secondary details fall into the background. Basically, this helps to soften contrast and to equalize areas, to equalize value contrasts, saturation contrast, colors, to group them all together a little bit more. And so the way that I do this in draw mode is to glaze on huge strokes of color, which will basically connect everything underneath it. And then I also like to lower the size with F as I get into smaller and smaller areas. All right, so I may have gone a bit too much with the edges of the creature. It's looking a bit very soft and like hazy and luminous. But in general, and especially when I look at the piece on a small scale, I really like how it's looking. I really like what it added to that. And so then if I join the keyframe so that we can see all of the changes that we've made so far, I mean, it's already looking like such a different piece. So these are the tools that I personally find make the biggest impact, have the biggest bang for their buck. But of course, there are lots more tools that we could experiment with, and I encourage you to try them out and see what you like. There is the draw tool in Vertex Paint Mode, and there are lots more tools in Sculpt Mode that I didn't even cover. And as I mentioned, you can hold Control to have any of these Sculpt Mode tools have the opposite effect. I think it's really impressive considering what a transformation has taken place in just maybe 15-20 minutes of filming this, when sometimes I've spent hours trying to finalize and render pieces in other ways, not using these tools, and I don't feel like the results were as great as this. But it's a learning process. I am definitely still learning, and I hope that by sharing this with you, it has been helpful. If you learned something today, please consider leaving me a like, subscribing for more Grease Pencil tutorials and general excitement. If you would like to support me further, I have a Patreon which aims to give a more in-depth look to my painting process with Grease Pencil. And as for social media, you can find me all over the internet at Sophie Jantak. So thank you so much for being here. I will see you again very soon. Take care. Bye.